I wouldn't mind seeing you a bit more. You know? Not just here, at work.
Sounds great. But no.
Well, maybe I could visit you on weekends.
It's a bit hard with a screw breathing down your neck all the time.
Didn't think of that. Jeez. Make it hard, don't they?
Yeah. Too right.
Well, at least we'll still be able to keep seeing each other here, eh?
Meg, I've just told the women about Pixie, so keep an eye on them.
Right. And Samantha?
Especially Samantha. I've just told her she can't see her mother.
Anyone at home, then?
Dennis!
Right. That's him, the one with the funny accent.
Hello, Dennis. Lovely to have you back.
I won't argue with that. The union smacked my wrist and told me to be a good lad.
Took them long enough to drop the suspension.
Well, they did, and you're back. That's the main thing.
I didn't think you were coming back till tomorrow.
Yeah, but if it's possible, I was hoping to get a few words with Bobby Mitchell.
Well, actually, it isn't. She's on work release, apprentice to an electrician, would you believe?
Oh, well, no, that's great news. She'll be terrific.
Yes, well, I better get back to it.
Well, I was hoping to entice you two ladies out to lunch, if you can spare the time.
Oh, I'd love to, Dennis, but I've got a mountain of work to catch up on.
Yes, and I'm pretty snowed under, too.
Nothing that won't wait till after lunch. And I'm sure Dennis would like you to tell him something about the new inmates while you're at it.
Well, what do you say, Meg?
She's the boss. I'll go and get my hand back.
Eat up, sweetheart. All your dresses will be too big for you if you don't.
Again, friend? I didn't hear you.
Oh, that pig throwing it down as though nothing happened.
What do you reckon Marge got planned for him, Jude?
I don't know, but it better be good.
You should eat something, Judy. Try not to worry so much.
I can't eat. I'm too upset. I'm glad you're eating.
It is Ahmed I do it for. And later.
At least someone around here's got something right going for them.
Oh, I don't know. I got all my money back that Lexi ripped off.
All right, Flop Ears. What's the big idea? It was a post-it till you got your rotten little hands on it.
You're jumping the gun a bit, aren't you?
I never touched the bloody...
Lying bitch, I gave you your money back.
Yeah, I know. So why would I want to touch it?
What's all the noise about?
Slackhead here decided to get tough on one of me posters.
Well, Warren?
I never touched it, Miss Ferguson. Will somebody tell her?
You tell her, Warren.
Yeah, come on, convince me.
Convince you? Your own mother couldn't...
That doesn't...
Hey, right. Oh. You're both on a charge. And you, if you're not eating, get out. And you sit down and shut up.
It's not fair, Jude, her accusing me like that.
Yeah, I know, love.
What are we going to do about it?
It's only a poster. The best thing you can both do is forget about it.
Forget about it? I'm on a bloody charge.
Oh, big dear, what are you going to do, Liz? Buy up? You want worse?
Not fair.
I don't know why I play this game. I've never got it out.
Want to talk about the robot idea? We thought we might start it this afternoon.
You're all right.
Aren't you going to thank me, Bunny Brain?
What for?
For rearranging Banjo's poster.
Was that you?
Well, someone had to show her what we do with her kind around here.
I'm in the poo because of what you did.
Well, it's not my fault if you make a lot of noise at the dinner table.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, what the hell's going on?
Oh, last time I do her a favour.
You all right, Marlene?
Yeah, no thanks to her.
Me?
Yeah, Lunch just told me it was I that ripped your bloody boy, bloody George poster off the wall, you stupid bitch.
It just seemed obvious, that's all.
But it sounds like the place hasn't changed all that much.
Certainly hasn't.
Good afternoon, Miss Ferguson. Good to see you again.
Heard you were coming back. Hope you stay with us as a bit more distinguished this time than the last.
Well, given a fair chance, it might be.
There was a phone call for you, Mrs. Morris, from the police. They said that Peter Wright's trial is being put forward to tomorrow. Did you phone them?
Yes.
A message.
Thank you. I'll phone straight away.
You all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
What's all this about a trial, Meg? I thought the Phil Cleary business was over with.
Oh, no, this is something else.
I think she can do without the questions, Mr. Cruikshank. I'll be in the library, Mrs. Morris.
Look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to stick my nose in.
No, it's all right, Dennis. But I do have to make this phone call.
Right. Well, thanks for lunch, Meg. It was lovely. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow.
Hasn't gone black, has it?
No, I think you'll live. I was a bit surprised you're landing well on Alice. I didn't know you had it in you.
Wasn't worth it. I got this big lump coming up inside me cheek.
Brain slipped, has it, Wally?
Get nicked. I would really have hired into you if the others hadn't held me back.
You and whose arm?
How's the face?
Been improved, I reckon.
You never give up, do you?
Come on, it's just a joke. Listen, you came the punch for me and I appreciate it, honest.
I made a king-size boo-boo, that's all.
What about the charge? Sorries aren't going to fix that.
I copped one too, you know. Anyway, if you hadn't been so pig-headed about your damn poker money, I wouldn't have thought of blaming you.
Pig-headed? You set me up.
Jeez, here we go again. Whoever invented you ought to be shot.
Will you knock it off? I've had enough now. Just knock it off.
Hey, come on, Mal. Come and give me a hand.
Sorry, Jude.
Yeah, me too.
It's all right. Stop bitching at each other, okay?
Listen, it was a dumb thing to do. I'm sorry about the charge, okay?
Fair enough.
I'm willing to give it a rest if you are.
Could only help things around here if we did.
Mates?
Mates.
Give yourself beautiful hair with a new formula. Formula.
Hi! Come to collect dirty linen, sheets and stuff.
Ah, yes, for laundry. I help?
Yeah, sure. Why not? Hey, you must be pretty desperate if you're down to the ads already.
No. I might say we must practice our English to be better talking with our friends.
He sounds as though he's got his head screwed on the right way.
Nice to know you patch things up with him.
Yes. I see Ahmed now is kind. Good man. Not what I thought.
So no more ideas about doing yourself in then?
Doing my what?
Don't worry about it.
I wish Maida was here so I could give her my blessings. She's such a good, strong woman. Help in many ways.
Too right. I reckon I could have done what she did in getting rid of Murphy, using Pixie like that.
I see Pixie when Ahmed helps me leave here.
Hey, you didn't tell us you were getting out.
Yes. Ahmed, he does the bail business.
Hey, that's great.
I'm sorry you don't get to see your mother, Sam.
Yeah, well, I think I found a way around it.
You still see her?
We'll see. Only way to get anything done around here is do it yourself, I reckon.
Sorry?
I'm, planning on giving myself a day release.
You, I don't understand.
No, sorry, weren't supposed to.
Oh, typical. Someone's torn my bloody page out.
You're supposed to be cataloguing the books, Frank. Not marking up the dirty bits.
Still playing my virgin wimp, are you, Paddy? You're worse than that bloody pixie.
Drop off, Frank. Not in the mood.
Oh, well, I was, mate. I reckon getting off with her was the best thing that happened to me since I got here.
You?
Yeah, that's right. I laid her right here. Right under Shakespeare. Give him something to write about.
What about Murphy?
Oh, poor bugger. Wrong place at the wrong time. What? I reckon I did us all a big favour getting rid of him.
Why, Frank? Why did you do it?
Easy. I enjoy it. Would have made your hair curl to see the look on her face. Unreal.
Last night I dreamed we were together, share.